that the supreme act of heroism is to stay out of the clutches of women.
Yeah, there are problems. When a Kryptonian crushes a human woman in his arms, she stays crushed. You probably are not able to mate a Kryptonian to a human woman except via artificial insemination, and even there you get problems. For instance, take a sample of Kryptonian semen, several hundred million sperm, attacking one unfertilized egg, are going to tear it into vapor, and then scatter because there's nothing to hold them. You'll have a sky full of Kryptonian sperm, invisible until they crack light speed, and then you get eerie blue lines of Cherenkov radiation. And in the meantime, little teeny holes in household pets, bricks, plate glass. What you want to do is take one Kryptonian sperm with a pair of tiny tweezers and put it in the right place. You can fertilize the egg that way. Even so, you get problems 6 months later when the baby starts to kick. The best answer I was able to come up with was ectopic pregnancy. Implant the fertilized egg under Superman's skin and let it grow there. We wind up with a pregnant Superman, and it may be unsightly, but it'll work.
Despite his enforced celibacy, Superman has made his contribution by being the inspiration for all the other superheroes who followed him. Basically, Batman, Green Lantern, and the rest are all variations on the same theme.
Well, the first thing you do, of course, is to make him very strong. So you develop a really powerful man. It doesn't matter his intellect. As a matter of fact, he's probably very dumb. But
Will Eisner, like his contemporaries Siegel and Shuster, is a legendary figure in comic book history. Today, he teaches a course at the School of Visual Arts in New York. His most famous creation was a Chandler-esque character called the Spirit. The Spirit was mysterious, but basically he was a down-to-earth hero and largely predates the alternative comics of today.
A superhero is, in effect, a character created by you to satisfy a fantasy need of the reader, because we're delivering fantasy.
I think superheroes are really played out now, and there's no place for them anymore.
Well, all right, let's kick it around. What do you think? You fellows have been working on superhero characters.
I don't agree, because you said before you should be sensitive to your market and your audience, and I think there's still a market for superheroes, even for children, and I think even for an older audience if the scripts are more literate.
But they make no sense. I mean, look at Supergirl. Every time she does something, Superman has to come in and pull her out of the mess. They don't even let her do it by herself.
Those scripts are aimed towards kids. I'm saying that there could be better.
Why does the woman always have to mess up? I mean, she doesn't even. There's no superhero for kids. There's no superhero for women. The superheroes are for 13-year-old boys with pocket calculators who think that they'll be him someday.
Okay, Lisa, what do you think about this?
Well, superheroes, I agree with Gwen that they're really, the ones that you see now in magazines are really overdone. And it seems that they do the same thing over and over again. I think what you need is a refreshing point of view and something that says something.
Okay, you want superheroes. Here's a hero for you, or at least a protagonist. Bobo Belinsky, he's the number one human zero. He's no big deal, stripped by Robert Crumb. When you think of all these four-color heroes running around bashing each other in and flying through the sky and all this grandiose activity, here's something at the opposite extreme, just Bobo sitting in a chair, diagrammed out into the various views, seen from above, seen from the side, completely static.
Essentially, it's the opposite, to superheroes. In that, instead of a ritualized story told over and over again, there's such a thing as finding new stories, and finding indeed where the border of storyline, what makes a story.
So what are you trying to do?
I don't have ongoing characters that repeat from strip to strip, except maybe myself, and it seems like a tradition that's well-rooted in 20th century art of the artist as hero.
This particular series of pages, Real Dream, involved little figures appearing on my hands, and the figures talk back to me and get me in trouble.
Where do you see the future of comics ideally lying?
Something that would wake a reader up rather than put him to sleep further. Things that tend toward genuine expressions of self rather than ritualized expressions of fantasy, things that make the reader work a little bit. There's actually something pernicious about this idea of the hero being foisted off on kids, basically. There's these good guys and there's these bad guys, and they bash each other out, and the good guy's sure to win. It's even overtly stated in the comics code that good must triumph over evil, and, well, things just ain't that way. It's fairly a simple thing to say, but things just ain't that way. And the problem with it is when America gets into a situation like we've been in recently in Iran, there's this tendency to feel, well, gee, like, I've had my glasses on long enough and my little Clark Kent suit, and it's really time to, like, get into some phone booth, pull it off, and stomp those foreigners, you know, this gang of evildoers, and show them that truth, justice, and the American way is going to really triumph one more time.
What do you think of the idea that Superman stands for truth and justice the American way?
Well, how could one stand for something which doesn't exist? It's very difficult, but he doesn't. For one thing, he doesn't. He comes at the last moment and flies through the air and helps. That's not what the girls normally, who I know, who have been raped and killed and mutilated. They don't need somebody to fly through the air. You know, policemen on the beat to see that this neighborhood gets on nuts in such a weird way. So the fact that to say Superman stands for right and stands for the good, that may have been beginning when these two schoolboys started. That may have been so. At the present moment, Superman stands for violence.
Every man has a job to do, and my job is doing good. Every night when the job is through, I fold my tights, proud to know I've done all I could. It's a satisfying feeling when you hang up your cape to know that you've averted murder, larceny, and rape. Every man has his job to do. Well, back into the old Clark Kent disguise. I'll never stop doing good. Oh, it's hard to keep on wearing the old Clark Kent smile, but I know I have to do it 'cause my work is so worthwhile. La-di-da, it's a funny life, still and all a life well spent. So here you go, bravery gone, meek and mild, glasses on, Superman, now you're Clark Kent.
Over here we have something really special. What this is a piece of birthday cake from a 35th birthday cake of Superman's at a convention 5 years ago held in New York. I know it doesn't look so great, but it's one of my special pieces, and it's the only piece left.